Yes, so abortion is one of the safest medical procedures that you can get, and it does not carry significant risks as opposed to other types of surgical procedures that you can get. One of the ways in which abortion rights get undermined is that people say there are psychological risks to abortion. The psychological risks in abortion come from a society that does not support abortion. You provide people the right kind of support, then the psychological risks go away. So that's why I'm thinking that way.
So I'm sorry, the alternative to abortion will also be presented, right? So does that mean that we don't want to discuss adoption? Is that?
I'm okay actually with discussing adoption. If we want to amend that and say alternatives to abortion will be presented, I'm okay with that. If we wanted to make that
adoption is a separate objective.
Thanks. Yes, 10.4, the students will discuss adoption as a positive choice in the gender and biological identity. Is it the same lesson as 10.3 or is it a separate objective?
I just think we need to be careful because, again, the code 22.1-207.1, when it talks about family life education, says the benefits of adoption is a positive choice in the event of an unwanted pregnancy. So we are required by law.
And we can have that.
Right, exactly. There actually is many studies that prove their emotional, psychological risk of abortion. There may be some disagreement, but there's definitely a plethora of evidence out there in research that does in fact show that there's, post-abortion syndrome, fear, anxiety, helplessness, guilt, pain, grief, depression. I could go on and on. There's the McGill study in 2013. There's the British Journal of Psychiatry, increased risk for mental health problems, 81% increased risk for mental health, 55% compared to unintended pregnancy. So there's not only emotional, but there's increased risk of breast cancer. I mean, there's tons of studies out there. LA Times in 1989, 56 experienced guilt, 26 regret. So there's newspaper articles, lots of references to issues that women suffer when it comes to abortion. So I do think we need to leave it in.
Anyone want to speak for the motion?
So, in other areas, we've decided not to provide medical advice. And I think here, we're moving out another thing where we're asking our teachers to provide medical advice to our children. Certainly providing information, unfortunately it's not on the agenda here, but it's in the very next section about adoption and alternatives to abortion. We're not taking that out in any way. We're just saying let's not have our team provide medical advice. So I support this.
Speaking against?
Sure.
Okay. So I think it's important to not say anything about the risks, I think it's really doing the kids a disservice. Obviously, opinions on both sides, very loaded, they're going to get information from other places, but to not say anything about the risks, I think is wrong. Anyone else want to speak to our motion?
I think we also know there are risks to carrying a pregnancy to term, so risks at all, that those should be included as well. Also in other areas, even on other topics, we've talked about being mindful of the lived reality of the students in the room and being careful not to make anyone feel shame. And there may, in fact, at the high school level, be students in the room who may have had an abortion, know someone who's had one that they care about. And I feel that this kind of language and conversation would make them feel very ashamed. And I don't think that's advisable.
So, I mean, we're wading into medical right when we start with the word abortion. I mean, we're getting into something that by definition is already a medical issue. Of course, there are multiple other contexts. We just had a discussion about, you know, use of PrEP and bringing something like that into a discussion. So the idea that medical information is not being presented in the mentality context, I don't think that really holds a whole lot of water. I think that, and so, I mean, if you're already kind of crossing that threshold, it's important to recognize that it's not, I mean, it's not just a societal sort of weight being placed on someone. You look at the legal framework of abortion. It's an extremely tight balance that you find, you know, justices making between the mother's concerns and the life of the child, to where, of course, abortion is not, you know, you can't generally do it past a certain point, that laws can be passed with regard to regulation of it past a certain point. And so, you know, we just, when we're talking about lived reality, the experience of a mother who is likely quite conflicted just on her own, saying, okay, I have this important consideration for myself, but then at the same time, there's something there. Again, we're talking about resources to help these people. The information, again, in this kind of an educational context, is not, I don't think, intended or designed to name or shame in any way, but simply to provide a greater factual picture.
Anyone want to speak for the motion? Against?
I think we need to be consistent with our curriculum. Taking it out does not keep us consistent with our curriculum in terms of talking about physical, emotional, and psychological risks of many other things that we talked about, sexual activity, becoming pregnant, even just in the general scheme of things and in our general health education class. I think we need to be consistent, and I think this should be in here.
Could you clarify how it's taught now? How is it progressing now? How in depth are you going into physical description of what it is?
There's a list that the teachers have to share with the students. They talk about possible physical risks, including discomfort, heavy bleeding, allergic reaction, incomplete abortion, and infection. It's a statement about several deaths have occurred following the use of misoprostol, and possible emotional and psychological risks, including anger, regret, guilt, and sadness. That's all we are telling the students right now.
Okay, all those in favor of striking information on the physical, et cetera, striking that sentence, please raise your hand. For striking.